This video is going to show you how to use Cyclone objects with Redshift. So what I've got fired up here is a whole bunch of presets that you will get in a download. So these are all now configured to work with Redshift. So what I've gone and done here, I've selected a cyclone, and I'm going to apply that to a spline. As you can see from the right viewport to the top left, that has automatically applied this fence to this new spline, and now this is fully parametric, so it really doesn't matter what sort of spline you add that to, it's going to build the cyclone object. If I just scroll through, you can see in this preset we have wooden fences, we have wooden handrails, there are wrought iron fences, glass handrails. There's a whole bunch of different styles for you to play around with and get familiar with how Cyclone works. Now let's fire up Redshift. You can see it's fairly quick. I'm using bucket rendering in this case. It's worth pointing out that at this stage we do not support IPR. We will do in the near future, but right now we only support standard rendering. So select the spline again, put that back to its preset, and I'm going to show you how to adjust this. So let's put a circle in there. Let's select the original spline and let's attach that circle. Not sure why you'd want a fence and a fence, but go back, select the cyclone, and now let's select the path, and you see that's going to update and it will work on multiple splines across your scene. So there you go, there you have it. There's a nice circular looking old style handrail. Wooden handrail, say you're doing a lovely sort of Victorian type house. That's the sort of thing you can do. Right, next, if you wanted to learn more about Cyclone, you can go straight from within the plugin to the help docs. Describes everything you need to know about it. Got training videos there as well. They should be quite helpful. And you can also learn about how the UV mapping works, because it is slightly different to normal. It's all based on maths, but it's all explained there. So download the sample Cyclone models and have fun. Thank you.